Hey everybody, my name is Ian. Welcome to the channel. I'm joined by my instructor, Sifu Joe Ludlow. Today we're going to be diving into some reactionary content with something that you might find interesting. It has to do with weapons. There's a lot of safety measures that come into play, but it does give you some insight about how scary real weapons can be. You ready, Sifu Joe?
Two things. One, don't do dumb shit. Two, the quality on here is, the video is not super high, so bear with us on that. But here you go.
Oh my gosh.
That dude just got whacked with an axe. Big, strong, buff dude. Metal training weapon, maybe? Little, tiny, wooden shield.
Plywood plank. Just.
Yeah. Like, it's like little maple.
That's insane. It's like. Man, I think that there's a lot to cover with this. For one, can you kind of just play that again one more time while I talk over this? It's for one, there's stuff that exists like this called HEMA that you can use, you know, much safer training tools and whatnot. But two, it just goes to show, like, even with using blunt weapons or something, how much damage, because he didn't even swing hard, and that went through both the wood and straight into his skin.
Well, and it's not even so people don't like when you're breaking boards, like you see the karate guys breaking boards, right? They're really breaking their first board, and then that board breaks into the next one. So sometimes you're not taking into account that axe probably didn't actually penetrate and hit the guy in the arm, but the wood that got did go into his arm, and it's just not being cautious enough. And then they got some like crazy teddy bear thing in the background.
I think that's a Five Nights at Freddy's thing or something.
Is that a Five Nights at Freddy's?
I think so.
This kind of would feel like a Five Nights at Freddy's. Like, this is.
Oh my gosh, man. I mean, you can't really see how bad that is, but like, just look at the, you know, it almost looks like his blood is that blood?
It drew blood, and I don't know if he's got wood in there or what, but hey, you want to see something not to do?
Train with real weapons.
This seems like a do not do this. Hey, Ian, why don't you put this shield on and let me swing this axe at you?
Well, what is the other guy swinging? Go back.
It's like a freaking, like, it looks like he just came from playing, look, it's like a croquet mallet.
Yeah, it's tenderized. I mean, even with that thing.
No, it is.
Yeah.
It literally is.
Oh, that's a croquet.
I don't know if you can see that or not, but that looks like he took that from a croquet set. He's out playing a little bit, hitting some balls, and then took it in with a piece of plywood.
I mean,
or whatever it is.
What are you expecting? You know, if, like, I wouldn't even play with the croquet ball, because if that hits you in the side of the knee, like, that's, you're done.
Yeah, as you were saying with the HEMA people, the people that I've run across in that world, they do actually use a lot of, they're very like, hey, here's our tools, here's our safety equipment, we know what we're getting into, we're going to be really cautious. They really take it seriously. That's something you want to do, is get into a really good organization, not just like, hey, Ian, do you want me to swing this thing at you? And no, don't do that. Which is crazy, because they have they're obviously in a gym with a ton of equipment in there. They should have a little bit of insight, but it can happen to anybody, I guess.
If anybody,
don't do that.
Yeah, if anybody
saying.
Tries to put you in a position, especially at a martial arts school where they're taking weapons off the wall, or, you know, because a lot of, like, especially Chinese schools that I went to, like, has a lot of ornamental weapons over on the wall. So if you see anybody pulling that off, trying to, you know, showcase that or whatever, that is not the school for you. Blockers will give you the same amount of training and let you make exponentially more amounts of mistakes before you ever run into an injury like that.
Yeah, you're trying to develop skills and then elevate those skills, not test out how you would do in a real situation. Anyway, yeah, don't do that. Learn from that mistake. Give us a like and throw your comments down below.
Subscribe for us too.